What's going on, YouTube? My name is Teeklin, and welcome back to episode 5 of our Mario & Rabbids Kingdom Battle series. And this time, we're jumping right into spooky trails. It's almost fall, my wife's already got our entire property decorated for Halloween, so what better time to jump into spooky time? I hope you enjoy. If you do, remember to smash that like button and hit the subscribe and the bell to turn on all notifications so you don't miss any future videos. Also, since we already mentioned Halloween, why don't you drop down in the comments and explain what is and why your favorite holiday? I think the only thing left to do before we jump in is to just say thank you guys again so much. This is my first departure project from Pokemon on this channel, and you guys have been blowing it out of the water. I could have never expected the amount of support that I've been getting on this series, and it's just mind-blowing. Don't get me wrong, I still love Pokemon. There's still plenty of Pokemon content to come. That's what we started with, and that's what we're going to keep rolling with. But there's so much more that I want to do and that I have slated already outside of that, and this is just the first of many. So, thank you guys again so much for the support. Keep blowing it up. Keep sharing this video to your friends if you think they'd enjoy it. And I'll keep putting out content for you guys to enjoy. That way we can build up on each other as we climb to the top. Without further ado, I think the only thing left to do is jump in, so sit back, relax, and let's see what Spooky Trails has to offer. So, looking at where we are right now, you might be a little bit confused. And let me explain. So, this is actually the second time I've recorded this intro. The first time I recorded it back at the hub of Princess Peach's Castle before we went through the canyon to get to Spooky Trails. Unfortunately, my recording software decided that it was going to do an update in the middle of my recording. And for some reason, that caused it to crash. Did it just stop the recording at the crash? No. No, it did not. What it did instead is corrupt the entire recording. So, everything from the beginning of the episode all the way to about halfway through the battle of at the end of 3-2 is recorded, but is unsalvageable. So, where we're picking up here is going to be the in-between of 3-2 and 3-3. So, I'm going to include a little recap here to show you what you missed. Okay, so when we first got to Spooky Trails, the first thing we found was a gate, and behind the gate there was some sort of creature. I'm assuming it was a Boo. Said his name was Tom Fan. Flip it around, that's Phantom. Fair enough. And then, as we proceeded through the battles, which were fairly annoying, we have the local Ziggies, the Hoppers, the Smashers, and then we have this thing. Now, these things are like the fast-paced snipers, and they can teleport anywhere across the map, and they have abilities to draw you into them by hypnotizing you. So, those are very, very fun to deal with, but that about catches us up with where we are, so let's go ahead and jump back in. But without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the rest of World 3, all the way up to the mid-boss this episode. So what we have here, this gramophone, I'm going to show back at the beginning area when we get there. There are two pedestals and two relics that we're supposed to be collecting. And when we collect those, it's going to open a gate. And that gate apparently has a great hero of the Mushroom Kingdom hidden behind it. I don't know what that means for us quite yet. But I suppose the only way to find out is to keep pushing through. See, here's the golden pedestal. We'll put this here. And it's gonna float there for some reason. Awesome. Alright, gate number 2 is open. Let's see what they're gonna give us. We're clearly on the right track. Let's see what our fairy godmother has to say. Right on time. Email, baby. Good job, you found one of the relics. Hopefully it was extremely unpleasant. Okay. Or unpleasant for your enemies, I mean. Yeah, our benefactor here is super sus. The second relic will involve a long and perilous journey during which you'll probably meet a grisly end. Have fun. I don't think this is the same benefactor. Certainly hope this Tom fan person is worth the trouble. Yeah, that is apparently the legend that we're following in Spooky Trails. It's the legend of Tom Fan. Yeah, that's the pedestal where the other one is going to go. And then if we go through here, that Disney-looking gate over there, that is the gate that's going to open when we get that second relic. So let's go ahead and go give it a shot. Oh, that's not terrifying at all. Let's see what we got. Hey, it's Toadette. Why do you people carry things on your head? Beepo swears? This game just got a lot more entertaining. Guys, you won't believe what happened. Toad wandered off, you got separated, now you need our help to find him again. Nope, we were playing hide and seek and then we got separated. Awesome. We love that. You know, we are heroes. It's not like we don't have quests and things. Beepo is based. So we get what's in the chest if we help Toadette. Oh my god. Why do we always get stuck with Toadette? She needs to solve her own issues every once in a while. Escort missions again. No. I don't want to. Jesus Christ, what the hell? Hey, we found Toad. Great. And that's a dub for Toadette. Let's go. How was I supposed to do that shit in 8 turns? What do you mean? Get out of here with that. Toad, stop. You run away one more damn time, and I'm gonna throw you into that cannon right there. How'd you guys find me? Shut the hell up, dude. One more game of hide and seek. No. Me too, Beepo. Alright, 3-4. Madam Boistrella? Oh my god, it's a reach area. Better than an escort mission, but still sucks. Holy hell. The Spooky Trails world. It's not even fun, honestly. Big hit. Oh, we got that crit push. Too bad fall damage isn't a thing. Thanks for shooting me in midair, buddy. Crit. Oh, he's big screwed now. Oh, we made it across. Frick. Oh, they're going to put bouncers. Oh, you. That's such a dick move, guys. That's free. Crit. Yes. Kick you. Eh. And you're dead. Beautiful! And Mario's still alive. No, he's not. Those things are gonna shoot Mario. I can feel it. Crit, please. Oh, yes. Oh, that's right. They can shield. The AI is getting smarter. And Mario's dead. Again. God, that didn't get recorded, did it? I don't remember if that was part of the recording that got corrupted or not, but Mario, like, died earlier. Kick and shoot. Yikes. I like how I've just ignored them the entire round, and it has served no consequence other than the fact that Mario died, but he was our team jumper, so he was gonna die from the beginning. What is this? You're all doomed. I figured that much, but okay. Doomed to inferior fortune-telling and outrageous prices if you see someone besides Madame Vostrella. Beepo talking about how he prefers science over mysticism, and then folding at the first sign of, maybe I have some information you want. Watch where you step. By the fountain, is that a boo or a balloon? Oh, that's the relic. All right. Pick up this relic. And let's go for it. Alright, let's go ahead and put down the second relic. Voila, our prayers have been answered. Now the moon gate should open wide for us. Disney time. Open the gate. It ain't opening. We did our part. We retrieved the lost relics. Beepo swearing again. Why isn't it open? It's not fair. Why is Beepo so angry? Like, I get it, but, like, he's so unreasonably angry. Oh. The moon gate. Gotcha. It's the wrong gate. Maybe there's a hotline we can call or something. Our anonymous patron is, again, pick the perfect time to lend a hand. Dorks, you're probably feeling pretty discouraged right now. Not that I blame you. I'd be discouraged if I were you, too. Does Bowser Jr. just email us? Because that's on brand. Moongate can't be open unless there's a full moon. Too bad it's gone already. Lucky for you, I know a way to get it to come back. Just take the totally non-spooky path leading from the gate that just opened, and everything will work out just fine, and you won't be killed, I promise. Okay. Works for me. To the gate. Yes. World 3-5. Yoshi! Yoshi Rabbit! Let's go! Oh, what the hell is that? Calavera, shade behind the shield? That looks horrifying. So we have two ghosts, a smasher. Alright, Peach, you're gonna go back here. Pop off. Thank you. You're gonna shield up. And Mario is going to jump, bounce off of you, and hide over here. The boss has 1100 health. Good God. At least we know he's not gonna have a second phase, I guess. Yoshi throws grenades. Oh, we might have a new addition to the team. Don't up the weapons. No. Critical to Jesus Christ. Alright, Peach, you are going to slide here. And you're gonna go over here. Push. Uh-oh. Don't hit, don't hit, don't hit. Bless. Healing up. Okay, Luigi. He's gonna go here. He's gonna crit the boss. Because his crit is amazing. And we don't need to use that yet. What we're going to do is we are going to slide into you. And we are going to team jump over here. And we shoot. And we shoot to kill. Oh. Don't spawn more enemies, please. That's fine. Blow me up. That's cool. Don't crit me. Oh. That's not good. Oh, there's gonna be more. I had a little bit of hope. But in hindsight, really shouldn't have. Okay. And I think that we're going to use the hammer. Bonk. No, I'm just going to... I'm just going to go here. I should have kicked him, but it's fine. It's whatever. We got the crit, and that's what matters. We're going to lower everybody's weapon damage. And Peach is going to go here. And boom. Oh, yes! We love to see it. We just got to survive the onslaught. Oh my God. Let's not, shall we? As long as we live, we're fine. God. Luigi, come on, man. Pick up the pace. slide. And we shoot. I think I've made an error. Honey shot, please. Yes! And now he is big stuck. There's this. We're gonna go back to Mario. Up the power. And I'm gonna get this fat crit again. This was not the time to not get a crit, Luigi. Not the Ziggy. We can nail this boss, though. I know we can. Okay, Luigi's down. That's fine. Try that again, shall we? All right. First time didn't go so well. Let's see what we can do this time. Oh, we didn't get the goop shot. That's not good. No, no, no. Please, no. Bad start. Boom. Oh, he's dead. What do you mean? What is that bullshit? What is that? This was a bad start. Explody car. Beautiful. Brit, yes. I just need Mario to make it over here. Thank you. I don't know if that hurts teammates, so I'm just gonna go with this. Jesus Christ. Mario's dead again. Yes! Kick. Heal. Big hit. It wasn't a crit, which is good. I just need the Ziggy not to ink either of them. Thank you. Okay. I don't see us ending it this round. Yeah, no, I don't think so. We're close, though. We're very close. Therosite, that's fine. Vampire, that's fine. Here we go! Luigi, finish him off! I'm so stupid. Boom! Got him! That's an L! What the f- We gotta add Yoshi to the team. I love him. He's my favorite. It fits to add someone like that to the team because Beepo is getting, like, rapidly unhinged. So, I'm here for it. Scatters enemies to set up the hero's counterattack with his scream. Hit up to 5 enemies in a row with his dash. 18 new powerful weapons. Alright, here we are in front of World 3-6, and that's where we're gonna call this episode. That way next time we can keep up our pattern of running through World 3-6 to World 3-9 and beating the boss. Who I'm assuming, and I was completely and totally wrong last time, but I'm assuming that this boss is going to be some sort of rabid King Boo hybrid, and I'm so excited for it. Anyway guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, remember to smash that like button and hit the subscribe and the bell buttons to turn on all notifications, that way you don't miss any future uploads. And please keep blowing these videos up. The feeling that I get when I can see that I've gone from videos amassing no more than 30 views over months and months and months versus 3-day time periods for these episodes resulting in almost 100 views apiece, that is insane. And it just makes me feel so good. It makes me feel like what I'm doing is showing the results that I'd always dreamed of. And I can't thank you enough for that. So like I said, keep blowing it up. I'll keep giving you guys content that you enjoy. And we'll just keep the ball rolling. As always, my name is Teeklin. You've been amazing. I hope you have an absolutely lovely rest of your day. I'll see you guys next time for episode 6 when we wrap up World 3.